Good evening. This is the Orlando Gardener coming at you down here in Winter Haven, Florida. And just wanted to do a interview with one of the subscribers and one of the individuals that came from out of town to visit the garden here in Orlando, well, over there in Orlando, and just wanted to get an understanding of how his experience and how he felt about the garden. Introduce yourself. Tell us where you're from and what you thought about the garden.
Hey, how is everybody? Well, I wasn't expecting an answer, but I'm Randy Griffin. I'm from Savannah, Georgia, but I came out to visit Elder Williams. He invited me to the garden, and when I went to the garden, I really didn't know what to expect other than what I seen on the videos, but the videos didn't do half of what was actually in the garden. Everything that's in the garden is amazing. You only getting a little sneak peek on the video, which the videos are amazing, but everything that was in that garden was amazing. I mean, I seen trees that I never even heard of, and he's so knowledgeable. The Orlando gardener is so knowledgeable about the trees that you feel like you know everything about the trees after you get finished talking to him. But I seen a variety of different fruits that I didn't even know existed. You had different mangoes and over 50 different mangoes, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes.
Then it had some terries that I actually got to try. It's just straight from the bush. It was Barbados terries.
Yep.
Amazing.
That's exactly what it was.
Then also he told me about a tree that I'll never forget, and he showed me.
Yeah.
It's called the moringa tree. The moringa tree, and that's considered the tree of life.
Yes.
And that tree, I couldn't get it. I haven't tried it just yet.
Yes.
But if I'm not mistaken, that tree contains just about every single vitamin that's needed for the body, so you can actually live off of that tree alone. So when I found out all of these things and I was actually able to pull the actual leaf off the tree itself and then just eat it, yeah, I was amazed. I was blown away. So if you get a chance to come out there, please contact the Orlando Gardener.
Yeah.
Do what you can to come out.
Yes. Yeah. So the what about the adventure walking through the garden?
Yes.
How did you feel actually coming through the garden?
I didn't know the garden was that big. It was almost like a maze. Like literally, I kind of got lost in the garden. So it was pretty dark, but it was pretty organized as well, because we had everything that was on the right side was certain types of fruit, then on the left side it had other certain types of fruit. But then even on top of that, it made a little path. So you can kind of just walk all through the garden. It was almost like a maze. That's the best way I can put it. I wish I could have words for it, but it was literally like a maze. It's huge, and it's amazing, and it's so organized. And if I can, it was another plant that I actually tried. Some type of red herb. I don't remember the name, but it was some type of
cranberry
red herb.
Hibiscus.
Yes, sir.
Yes, cranberry hibiscus.
But I was blessed enough to try that plant, and that plant was amazing. Now, what I do know about that tree, though, is you can't eat too much of it at one time.
That's right.
So you do have to be very selective on how you eat it, but it was amazing.
You're absolutely right. And we're very grateful to have had Brother Randy to come down from up north to visit us. We're actually in Winter Haven right now, but he came down in the earlier part of the year just to visit the garden. And we've had numerous other people to come down from different states and different places. And we're just very grateful for that opportunity to have him down, and just wanted to share his experience with the rest of you subscribers. So y'all have a blessed weekend, and we'll see you when we get back to Orlando. God bless.